Hey everyone, it is I, Jungle Josh, once again. We do another Dark Souls. Alright, so I'm kind of irritated because the footage I had for beating the last giant was corrupted and super, super annoying. So, we're going to go ahead and join someone's game so I can show you the boss battle. And you know, it always helps going into this boss, or going into bosses in general, as a human, because you'll see signs of either NPCs you can invite or other players, because you can't summon people if you're not a human. So if you're hollow, you can't summon, but you can still put down your signs. See all these signs right here? We can summon, who's this? Pete? Remember, he's the guy that that drops you, or that locks you away in the thing earlier in the gate, and that was really annoying. And then Sellsword Luet. He's actually new. I don't remember him being in the original, but we're gonna put our sign down here and we're gonna play the waiting game for a little bit. Well, see, we didn't have to wait that long. All right, here we go. See, he summoned us into the world, and he also looks like he summoned the other two guys, the other two NPCs. And we're about to go ahead and fight this bad boy. Almost ran right. Nope. Nah, he's gonna do that stupid stomp thing. But for some reason, the bosses here are more focused on the person who's like the real person. The summoner, I guess, would be the best. See, he ripped off his arm, so he got a little bit of time to do as much damage as you can. Oh, Lord! Heal up. No! Oh, I should have died, honestly. I thought it was. Hey, we did it! We did it! We did it! Hooray! So yeah, that was pretty easy. Especially when you have four people knocking it down. Two NPCs and two real people. But yeah, helping out people is actually has many, many benefits. You gain a bunch of more souls, and you don't have to worry about losing your souls either, because you're kind of like you're a phantom in another world, so you don't lose your souls. But if you beat them, you get a partial amount of souls as a person, the real person who did the summoning, and you turn human. So if you're out of human effigies, just go to a boss and go ahead and get summoned and do the battle and win. You'll turn human. So that's if you're kind of stuck fighting the boss and you want to help other people. But it's also based upon levels. So don't become super high level and then come back to a lower level place and then expect to be summoned, because the chances are very, 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 very unlikely. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and continue our epic battle. Yeah, screw these guys. These guys are a pain in my butt. Oh, dang, it was not. Oi. Alright, come on, guy. Mono y mono. You and me. All right. Good. Screw that guy. All right, so we're going on to the next boss, who's pretty much the end of the level. And maybe we'll... Hey, look, you soldier key. This is pretty much a... Because there's two bosses. This is the one that... Remember earlier how I was going to try to fight him, but I ended up dying right before he can get summoned. Oh, okay, guy. So yeah, this is him, and we'll try and summon some people to help us out if there is any. And you might notice a little green aura around me. Well, I found a ring when I was playing yesterday before everything got corrupted. And it gives me a faster stamina regen. So it's always very, very, very helpful. Oh, man. Almost died and would have lost being human. Would have been a waste. Yeah, so arrow guy up here. As you can see, there's already a sign for someone to be summoned. Okay, you don't want to notice me? And there's different kinds of signs you'll see. If you see ones that are like a lot brighter than some others, or maybe gold, they're part of a secret coven that if you are familiar with the Dark Souls characters, it's kind of the one that Solaire belongs to. Praise the sun and all that good stuff. Who is this? Caracos. So there's a... Ah, dang it, the sign disappeared. Shame. But there's a pattern to fighting the Crusader. It's easier if you have a buddy who can lure him into a corner. And then there's this giant crossbows you can shoot at him. They're kind of like environment hazards. But you can kill your friends. Or whoever you summoned. Trust me. It happened. Because I was helping someone out and I lured him into the corner. But I didn't get out of the way and the arrows shot me. Because they'd pass through him and into the wall. So just remember that. Arrows are bad. Good or bad. Or friendly. Oh, there's a guy up there. Friendly or non-friendly. They are, they hurt. Let's see if I can summon these guys, the NPCs. Maybe they'll follow me. Yeah. Because I think you can summon up to three other people. Including these NPCs. Why is he... Whoa, he's scary. Why is he red eyes? I never noticed he had red eyes before. That's new. Alright, we're gonna try to summon him. An actual player, because sometimes they're a lot smarter. Oh, not sometimes. All the times they're a lot smarter than NPCs. Because NPCs will go right into the battle. It's always good to give a friendly hello. Hello, buddy. Send Chaos 29. Let's go this way. You're gonna help me fight him. Alright, enough of my little British accent. I guess they can't leave that area. Come on, guys. No, stupid. Now, hopefully he saw that I was waving to him. That he can follow me. There you go. You're a smart lad. Alright, I guess the NPCs can't leave the room. That's fine, though. That's fine. We don't need them. Kitty, off the counter. Alright. I doubt we're gonna die. Because he's actually pretty easy, even if you don't use the crossbows. He's pretty easy. He's got dodges attacks. He pretty much shows his attacks before he uses them, so easy to dodge. But don't get caught in his combos, because he will rip you up. Alright, hey, we'll summon another guy here. Because, you know, it's better to have, the more people you have, the easier the battle is. Unless you want to be a hard charger and be like, oh, I'm going to do this without summoning people. Well, you know, it's better in numbers. Yay. Rawr, war cry. Rawr. All right, guys. Let's do this. You ready? To the Punisher. I think that's his name. Ka-ching. Yeah, if you fought him early, you wouldn't have to go through this, which is nice, because you have barely any room to maneuver. Yeah. You can get that weapon. It won't be that size, but it'll be a great sword, and you can use it. I can't remember how you get it, but you get it. Come on, guy. Come on, take his aggro. Okay, he's gotta line him up. Oh! See how I accidentally... Oh! And I almost killed him too. Come on, guy. Yeah, remember I was telling you how crossbows hurt, or arrows hurt, friend or foe? I was not lying. See, that is very dangerous when it glows like that. And he can destroy those crossbows if he sees you using them. He will try to go after you. I feel bad now, because all that guy wanted to do was help. Ooh! Yay! We did it! Hooray!
Ring of Blades.
Awesome. I'm glad we did it, guys. We're so cool. But yeah, after you beat a boss, usually they disappear like that. And once you beat them, you're done. You can only fight them if you get summoned. And so we picked up a ring as well. See, you can wear up to 4 rings, and it increases physical attack. Nice. Alright, good. I still got the fast roll. So always look around. We're gonna drop down here because there is a fantastic armor set that if you didn't really know about it, you would have missed it altogether. Yeah. Man, don't worry. We'll come back to these guys later. And if you go up those stairs, it brings you to the new area. But like I said, we're going to go ahead and drop down here. Oh, I should have left a note. Because you can leave a note telling people, hey, you know, come down here. See, look, we got that all that whole set right there. So we're going to put it on. I might not be strong enough to use it. I don't think I got a helmet. See, but it is heavy, so my weight, I might, this is going to be a bit rough. What was it called? See, this sword, see, this one does about 200, because that's including the flame damage, and this one does 180, though the stats are better. See, I can't even use it correctly right now. Yeah, see how my guy's a little bit heavier now? So the rolls aren't as fast. Oh, of course there's a big fatty bobladdy in the way. Yeah, that's the only thing about that. Oh. Yeah, we're just gonna run. What is that guy doing? So I'd say I might switch off the armor. Because I like rolling. Whoop! Oh god! Run away! So we're just gonna go ahead and continue on. You can hear him. Yeah, we're just gonna continue going on. But first, we'll switch up my armor. See, but we get a stat boost from wearing the all the might be able to increase my weight carried, so I won't be all fumbly bumbly like that. Birds. Vision of fatty, therefore try stomach. See, this is the same bird that carries the crusader around. If you didn't notice. Ooh, chesticles. Now this is a fun area. No, it is not. I lied. I am sorry, guys. But these guys suck a lot. Dole Ember. But, so yeah, we'll light this, and we're gonna go back to town. Dang it. I did not. I'm just gonna go pretty much right back to where I came from. We wanted to go to Majula. I do. Here's moving back to Majula. Majula Ablingata. Come on, lady. Hurry up and get up faster. Seek the king, lest. Yeah, so we're gonna head and equipment load. So what increases our equipment load? Vitality? So we're gonna put all in vitality. But yeah, every time you do that, it increases your overall level. Excuse me.
you, you.
What you buying?
No, I need Trinet Shard. Well, since I'm here, I'll go ahead and increase this bad boy. Alright.
I'll be around.
It's always, every time you beat an area, always come back. Because there might be someone new, you know, a door might be open, or, you know, some of the vendors will have new items to sell. So always come back and check it out.
Oh, hello again.
See, he has this fancy new shields. And a bunch of new armor set, but he doesn't have anything else.
Well,
Rawr. Okay. So we'll continue down that area. I did pick up this item. Whatchamacallit, where is it? Right here. There's only a little bit of them, like 5 to 10. And you need them to, like, unpetrify some people that are blocking your path or are holding something that you need to progress. Like, remember how I showed the video with that person that was holding on to the handle? Yeah. You give it to that person. And a couple other people. There's actually one in the tutorial that's blocking a path, which is weird. I've never seen it like that. I did go back because I felt like I was missing something. Alright, let's continue. Oh, these guys are fun in the buns. Okay.
Don't want to fall off the edge.
Okay. Try my left. Ah, yes. Okay. There we go.
Hey, guy. Cool.
Heck yeah, that's what I need, right? Large Trinet Shard. Rawr! Ooh, yes. This is where I always have one of these things, a firebomb, just in case. That's why. And y'all noticed how now I can roll fantastically because I increased my weight. So always do that if you can, because then you'll be getting heavier armor later on and you will need to be able to I could have just pushed this off. That's right. Nope, not anymore. You can't just be able to push that off. Oh, and we go. Beware of enemy in short track attacking. Oh, no. Danger zone! Be wary of this is what I think it is. Nope! Oh, what the heck? He's back. And he wants vengeance. Just gotta take our time, guys. Oh. Oh, man. Oh, man, that hurt. You know it. Ha ha! Not so tough now. No, 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 no. Hey. 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 Aww. There's no secret. Well, we had our chance to fight another one. Got another ring. What is this? Oh yeah, fallen foes yield more souls. Giggity. Alright. We'll call it quitsies here, because it's already been 25 minutes. But, there we are. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!